Welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today we continue the sound design series here at BusyWorksBeats.com/sound design. Today I'm going to show you how to completely morph sound. Just to think of it as one big experiment on an experiment on an experiment on an experiment. So let us start. So this is the rabbit hole of sound design. So first I'm going to start with a blank patch. I'm just really going to just do random stuff, really random things. I want the pitch to go up over time, so I'm going to tell the pitch to go up in attack to the max value over time. So let's record that into Edison. So what I do is I record my patches a lot. So let's open up Edison, hit record, let it play out. And it didn't do anything because we're not in pattern mode. Okay, so now I'm going to take this patch and then do something crazy with it. So you could take it and work with it as audio. Let's grab it and let's bring it into the channel rack. Let's open up Fruity Granulizer just to see what we can mangle with this thing. And let's play some key. Now, Granulizer is a little more difficult to wrap your head around because it's not visual. But if I open up a Wave Candy... You like candy? Let's open that up. Now you can hear those stutters, those glitches. It's dropping out samples. So it sounds like it's a trance gate almost. So it's speeding up the sample and then chopping it into slices. So if I pull the GR spacing in shorter, it's gonna sound faster. And it's also gonna have like an edge to it. Like a slicey kind of sound to it. And if I spread it out with more spacing, it's still slicing it, but it's giving it more room to develop the full sound. I like this kind of sharp sound actually. Now I'm not sure what wave spacing is, but it sounds cool. Whoa. So now it's flipping the sample, I think. Wave spacing, I could probably come up with a concept behind it. I just don't feel like thinking right now. So I'm just gonna mess with the knob. I like that tone. Just need a little more scoop. There we go. Okay, now I'm gonna add some effects to it. Whoa, that's dope. Okay, so let's record that. So we went from, I'll show you where we started from where we're going to end up. Let's send that to track two, one, and then let's record a new patch. Record. Okay. Where we stop. Okay. So now we have that. That is a new sample. I'm trying to manage. It's like cooking. So many pots going on at one time. Let's zoom in. Let's grab that. Zoom in, make sure we grab the whole sound. Let's drag this audio back into the channel rack. Now I'm going to give this an envelope. So I'm going to work inside the sampler itself. And we're going to go to Mod X, which stands for the filter cutoff. I'm going to set the minimum value first, or else you're not going to hear anything. Turn on your envelope. It's set to a low pass filter. And I want this to have a high amount. So it's going to start open, go closed over time, based on my decay curvature. And I like how there's still a little something going on afterwards. Okay, so let's take that sound. And you're like, what are we gonna do with this crappy sound? Let's run it through some processing. Let's open up Fruity Compressor. Set it to 4:1 or higher. And then we're gonna simply lower the threshold. Now I'm gonna make sure it cuts itself so it doesn't overlap the sample. So now we have more of a... So here's without the compressor. Okay. So Now what can we do to make it weird? Okay, now I'm going to start thinking mixing tools to make it sound weird. So let's insert this into the playlist. So when you're really sound designing, you get your hands messy. I mean, everything's not going to be on the grid. You're going to have stuff all over the place. But I'm going to keep this fairly tame as far as experimentation. So now what I want to do is introduce stereo. I don't think we have stereo yet. I think we're still in mono. I could be wrong. Yeah, we're still mono. Okay, so I want to make this stereo over time. But what I want to do is make it expand into stereo versus just starting stereo. So let's open up an imager plugin. You don't need this particular plugin. We have a whole free course on how to make your sound stereo at Busy. Just type in how to mix beats easily, BusyWorks Beats. It'll pop up the free course. What I want to do here is turn on the stereorize mode of Isotope and just pull out the bands which I want to stereorize. So I want to pull out low mids. And I want to give this more of a time delay. There we go. And I also want some reverb, but I want the reverb to kick in really late. So let's do Fruity Reverb 2, pull it stereo. Okay, you could also do it this way to create stereo, but it's gonna have the reverb tone to it. Now we're gonna pull up pre-delay. I like to cut out bass in my sounds. And I wanna cut down my decay time so it hits once. Okay. So what I'm gonna do now is right click the wet level, I think. I always forget which one, if it's the mix level or the wet level. I think it's the mix level. Let's right click, no, it's the wet level because that's the audible level. So let's right click, create automation clip. And I want my reverb to die out whenever I tell it to. So I don't want it to last forever. So I'm gonna tell it to cut. So let's tell it to cut earlier than what it is set to cut for. So you can even add little dips. So it goes doing a wink. And then you can have it reintroduced at an even higher level. And I'm gonna have it swell and reverb. And instead of having a 0 to 1 kind of thing, I'm gonna do a gradual introduction because I find that easier on the modulation. Now I'm going to pull up the decay time a bit so you can hear what's actually going on. Okay, so that's what's actually going on with the reverb. You probably couldn't tell that from before. Okay, so now what I need to do is modulate the stereo. So let's right click, create automation clip. And I want it to stereorize over time. Now I want the stereorizer to be last. Let me see here. Thing is, let's just make the reverb not stereo. I think I'm doing this backwards. There's nothing I can modulate in this plugin to make it stereorize over time. And also it's going too slow. So let's pull the max value here. What I could do to override this is take it from the stereo separation knob. I could do it that way. Pull it mono or merged. So everything is turning mono, but you got to be careful with this because it controls everything. So it's overriding all the reverb, all the imagers. So now I'm forcing it to start mono and then open up to stereo. And you can get rid of the isotope imager. So this is extremely advanced, and that's because this is the quirky world of real sound design. Real sound design, you dig into the depths. But once you learn the basics, it's pretty easy to start experimenting with all this type of stuff. You don't have to make it seem so complicated. Let's get rid of this. Let's turn on my reverb. Now, I don't know why it should be doing, I did it backwards. So it should start merge, then go stereo. Not sure why it's not starting at 100%. Merged. Maybe it is. It's just not showing it. So I'm going to have it linger around mono a little more. So it feels center, and then it feels like it's hitting you on your stereo sides. So we're creating, like, you know, movie type of sounds. Now, of course, the pitch bending sounds a little awkward. So you could, not awkward, but let's pitch it down. Under the main tab, let's pitch it down an octave. I did plan on adding Fruity Squeeze to the sound, but it was getting really chaotic, creating clicks, and it messed up the video because it was so clicky. So let us see what else we can do to this to make it robotic. I'm thinking Fruity Wave Shaper at this point. I also want to have a moving filter. Okay, so this is going to get... I don't want to make this too long, but let's open up Parametric EQ 2. And we need two bandpass shapes. So let's change this to a bandpass shape, and let's change, looks like we can't double up on bandpass. That's, oh yeah, we can. Okay, it's a little lopsided. I don't know if they will move independently. Looks like they will. Okay, so now we have two bandpass, but I had to crank the level all the way up. Let me make sure we're not clipping or anything. So it's pretty, it takes out a lot of volume. You can go back and add volume as needed by going to the wrench tool, turn up level. Okay, but I don't want to like blow out your ears if something changes. So let's open up Parametric EQ 2. I'm going to change the band wave, the band width curvature here for each, for each one of those resonance points. And it was still getting a very low volume, which is really weird. I'm trying to think of a better way we can do this instead of doing it this way. Let's just reset it. We can just create two bands that sweep through. I don't know why I did it the hard way. But the thing is, we're not getting volume dips. So I'm going to create a notch filter as well that's going to sweep. So what I want to do is have these sweep independently of each other. I'm going to set up what's called a Fruity Formula Controller, which will... It's like a built-in LFO, so I'm going to right-click, go to Basic Sine LFO. And this is, let me rename this. I'm going to call it LFO 1, so I know which one. We're going to go into Parametric EQ 2, and I'm going to right-click one of the frequency bands and link it to controller, internal controller, LFO 1 out. Now I'm going to create another Fruity Formula controller, right-click, Basic Sine Wave again. It's going to be at a different speed. Let me rename this and call it LFO2 so I don't mix them up. Go inside Parametric EQ2, grab 0.2 frequency, right click, link to controller, internal LFO2 out. So now I have two separate LFOs controlling those points. Now I need another LFO. So let's go to Fruity Formula Controller, right click, Basic Sine LFO, and rename this. You guessed it, LFO3. Go back into the Parametric EQ2. Right click on the yellow frequency, link to controller, changes to LFO3 out. So now we have three LFOs controlling all those knobs. So I'm going to set these to random values just to hear them move over time. Let me turn this down. I think I cranked up the volume, so let me reset everything. So they're just moving chaotically, randomly. So that's what's happening. So let me give values to each of these. In different speeds. It'd probably be better to do separate parametric EQs. I want this just to be random though. So a lot of movement going on. Just random phasing, basically. So let's say that's too much for you. You can always turn the mix level down. So these points aren't sharp enough for me, so I'm going to turn up what's called the bandwidth, Q. I want to pull these up in volume as well, so I can hear them a little more clearly sweep. now I have like a boom, boom type of sound. And I'm just going to blend that in. So that's just adding an extra tone. Didn't really do much to the sound, not as much as I wanted, but I'm trying to keep the video kind of short. So where's our free wave shaper? Let's use this. Turn the mix level down first. So I'm trying to introduce robotic types of sounds here. So what I want to do next is add Fruity Chorus. Let's pull this up. I'm going to pull it up in the chain so it comes, whoa, so it comes before everything. Actually, let's change this out for like a flanger or a phaser. It's for more aggressive chorusing. Now let's open up Vocodex. I want to see if we can add a little bit of a rubbery square tone to it. I'm not sure if this takes direct sound or if you need to route sound into it, but let's see. Okay, so so what I want to do is mess with this gender knob, and I want to see if that actually changes the tone. If it does, I'm going to see if we can create an automation clip for the gender knob, because that would make a big difference. It just changes the tone. It doesn't really do much to it. Let's change the, here we go, the band distribution knob. I think I'm using the right knob, or the bandwidth, sorry. So I'm also gonna crank up the wet level. Let's add more voices, two voices, let's detune them. Pan them stereo. I'm up to 44 voices. Actually, I don't like four, I like two. So let's create an automation clip for both of these, the female knob and the band with knob, just to make them sound crazy. Now what I want to do is pull it down another octave, because that's the original tone. And now we have like a Gears of War type of sound, like if a bat was flying at you, like the krill, this could be like one of those sound effects. So you can get so in depth with sound design, it's ridiculous. That's why I say when you learn mixing, you can take your sound design to a completely new level. If you want to learn mixing, go to busyworksbeats.com/mixingacademy. Mixing is half, if not more, the half of sound design. I think that's a cool final sound. Very just weird. Wanna add another bigger reverb at a longer pre-delay time. Turn up the wet level, increase the size of the room. So just really weird sounds you can create. So this is like, again, tip of the iceberg. You could spend hours and hours on sound design. I mean, there's endless possibility. So that's the rabbit hole I was talking about. So if you want to learn more about sound design, you want to go to busyworksbeats.com/sound design to learn a lot more. It's a free course on sound design for beginners. So I walk you through each fundamental of sound design, and we lay it out in a simple form for you. So click that link below or go to busyworksbeats.com/sound design. Thanks for watching. It's busyworksbeats.com.